So, bad agronomy means we have to improve the sericulture production. In the meantime, maybe we have to increase the yield of mulberry, or maybe increase the cocoon production, reduce the drudgery, okay? Especially we work on productivity.
Okay. Commercial purpose.
Productivity in the sense, for example, let us say this is 1 acre land.
Okay.
1 acre land is there.
Yes.
From this 1 acre land, you are getting 50 kg cocoons. This is the production.
Yes.
But from this 1 acre land, if we can increase, land is same, but the production we have to increase. That is known as a productivity. Maybe 60 kg or 70 kg like this. For this, mainly it is prone to different kinds of diseases. So we arrest the diseases, or if disease is there, we develop certain disinfection management, or maybe some tools, diagnostic tools, so that we can, early detection is possible. Generally in sericulture, what happens, by the time you detect the disease, it is there all in your bed and they start dying.
Okay.
So before that, at least 4 to 5 days earlier, if you can detect the disease, then what happens, you have time to manage the things. At least 50% crop loss can be saved. Especially in wild silkworms, what happens, the moment you see the disease, almost all worms will well know. Okay, so in wild silkworms, if you can detect the disease at least 4 days ahead, disease in the sense only by seeing visual symptoms only will come to know. But molecular-biologically it takes some time, incubation time and all, pathogen and all. So at the early detection, it is possible to save your crops. So such type of things we do. Like you are working on, what you say, recently we have seen nosema.
Yes.
So we are going to develop a diagnostic lab technique as well as LFA technique. LFA technique means it is just like your rat test.
Yes.
It is just a strip coated by antibodies of nosema. Okay, antibodies generated against nosema.
Yes.
So you have to keep your sample and you have to see. Because what happened generally, how would you see under microscope this nosema? By a method known as Fujiwara.
Yes.
When the pepperin is in the spore form only, you can able to see.
Yes, sir.
For example, let us say a sample is there is no pepperin spore. Do you show that 100% it is pepperin free? Pepperin may be in a vegetative stage, where you could not trace back in the light microscope.
Yes.
See, we generally thought that, yes, there is the microscope, you have to see 600X and see pepperin spores. If pepperin may be in the vegetative stage, pepperin has different developmental stages, right?
Yes, sir.
Both vegetative and only at the spore stage only we can able to see. See, we used to give for DFS to the farmers. Still they get pepperin. From where the pepperin is coming, there is a chance of, false positive or false negative in your microscopic studies. But whereas this rat test and molecular biology test, it does not depend on whether spore is there, vegetative stage is there, nothing. It just depends on the genetic material of a pepperin. Pepperin genetic material is DNA. So if DNA is there, obviously we will detect. But this lab will work on the protein of spore. Every spore has a spore wall protein.
Yes, sir.
Pepperin is there, whether it is in vegetative stage or spore stage, its spore wall proteins will be there. That can be detected. That type of project is doing one girl. Okay, you can see some lab infrastructure. This is open for making your DNA gels. DNA gels. Agro we have here. So this is table top.
DNA gel.
This is our minus 30. Where we keep over the reagents and gels and all. You can see the temperature also here. Minus 30. But what happens when we work on RNA? See, DNA is a double stranded DNA. DNA has stable at room temperature also.
Yes, sir.
But RNA is very sessile, very immediately it will degrade. So you have to store RNA at minus 80.
The silkworm, either by using the biotechnological tools, you identify for identification of, for example, some genes you have to identify. So you want to remove that gene from the silkworm because it is it may not be it may be involved in some disease disease in silkworm. So now you don't want that gene. So either you remove that gene or you add that gene. So all these kind of things can be done through biotechnological applications. So here basically we are concentrating on application how biotechnology can be applied in sericulture to improve the silk yield. So these are the only two aspects. So basically this lab is involved in molecular pathology, means identification of the diseases. So most all the labs are doing the same thing, first identification of the disease and then what is the way forward. You have identified the disease, so how you will use the biotechnology to identify that or how to improve that. So these are the only two ways. So here presently already we have worked on two projects, that is through RNAi technology to knock down the genes for NPV, and also we have identified some of the genes involved in filament characters, the filament what is there, the silk thread what is there, so what are the genes involved, how they are behaving, because you already know we have bivoltaine and multivoltaine. What is the main difference between bivoltaine and multivoltaine? That is one thing. Other than that,
it's not either color, shape, size, not type of
instrument is something not strength is.
Yeah. So the one is what you told is the generations, that is the diapause what we call. So this doesn't undergo diapause and this undergoes. Then moreover in India you know that especially in South India it is fine. Everybody are adopted to bivoltaine sericulture. But if you go to northeast in Berhampur, because of the very tropical climate, high humidity, high temperature, so all these things are not suitable. Generally, we know it is very very specific around 25 degree and humidity. So in those conditions, our normal bivoltaine silkworms, as such the pure bivoltaine silkworm may not survive, because all our bivoltaine, you know, they are from the temperate origin. Means either we have got it from China or Japan, we made a hybrid here. So they will have the blood of temperate region. Means though you made so many changes and over the years, almost 30 years we have reared here, but still some of the bivoltaine pure characters are still there in bivoltaine. So they may not, they are either, so they are most susceptible to disease. All we all know that bivoltaine, they are most susceptible to diseases. But in the contrary, the quality of silk what they produce is really international grade, so that is 3A, 4A grade silk they produce. When you come to multivoltaine,